In this illustration, we'll discuss about a uniform rod on two rollers. Here we are given that a uniform rod is placed on two spinning rollers symmetrically as shown in figure, and the friction coefficient between the rod and rollers is mu, and we are able to find the time period of small oscillations of rod if it is slightly displaced horizontally and released. Here first we need to understand the situation. We are given two rollers on which a uniform rod is placed. Here we can see if the rollers are spinning in clockwise and anticlockwise manner. So, the direction in which friction would be acting on rollers would be opposite to their spinning direction, and on rod it will be in the direction opposite to the friction acting on the rollers. Initially, when the weight is acting at its central point, the normal reaction at both of these rollers would be equal. Say these are N and N, we can say the value of N will be mg by 2, because 2N will be equals to mg for the equilibrium of rod in vertical direction. And when we slightly displace the rod towards right, say by a distance x, we can say the center will shift by a distance x, and now this is the point where mg would be acting. This was the initial position where mg was acting, and this after distance x, when the rod is shifted, mg would be acting here, due to which this normal reaction will become n1 and this will become n2, where n1 would be certainly greater than n2 because mg is shifted toward the rightward roller. So, in this situation, the friction will also be, this is f1 and this is f2, which are acting on the rod. So, here we can first calculate N1 and N2, and in turn we can get the value of friction, and difference of the two will be the restoring force on rod, which will tend it back to the initial position. So, here we can write for equilibrium of rod after displacing it by x, we use, say, if this point is A and this point is B, here we can write, we use torque about point A. Here we can write about point A, torque is due to N1, which is N1L minus, it is due to the weight, which is mg multiplied by L by 2 plus x. And this should be equal to 0 because the rod is in equilibrium for its rotational motion. So, this implies here we get the value of N1 directly as mg by L multiplied by L by 2 plus x. Similarly, we can write the torque about point B, where the torque due to N1 becomes 0 and it is only due to N2 and its weight. So, we can write it as N2L minus mg multiplied by L by 2 minus x, because the distance of mg from this point B is L by 2 minus x. This distance is L by 2. This is also L by 2, as initially the weight would be acting at its midpoint. This should also be 0, which gives us the value of N2, that is mg by L multiplied by L by 2 minus x. So, we can write the restoring force on rod is, this restoring force we can write this as F1 minus F2, which is mu times N1 minus mu times N2. If we substitute the values of N1 and N2 over here, this restoring force becomes mu times mg by L multiplied by L by 2 plus x minus L by 2, again this plus x, so this L by 2 gets cancelled out, and this will result as MA if A is the acceleration of rod with which it is having a tendency to return back. So this gives us acceleration as equals to, here we can cancel out M, and this will be 2 mu g by L multiplied by x. And as A is opposite to X, so we can write as A is in direction opposite to X. This implies we can write A as minus 2 mu G by L multiplied by X. Or we can compare it with A is equals to minus omega square X. So here we can write it comparing with A minus omega square X, because here acceleration is directly proportional to X. This implies it is executing SHM. This implies rod is executing SHM at omega is equals to root of 2 mu g by L. This implies its time period of oscillation is 2 pi by omega, which is 2 pi root of L by 2 mu g. That will be the final result of this problem.